Although Satan is a defeated foe, God has given him permission to rule over this world system, which is totally corrupt. Satan's purpose is to blind the hearts and minds of people to the gospel. Millions are deceived. Religion is one of Satan's ways of destroying your soul. But Jesus came to save your soul. Satan has multitudes following the teachings of Buddha. But Buddha is dead. He's powerless to save, for he was only a man. Ancient pagan religions worshipped Astarte, known as the Queen of Heaven. Today, millions of Roman Catholics unknowingly worship this same pagan goddess as the Virgin Mary. God himself commands in his holy word, "Cursed be the man that maketh any graven or molten image. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. This is an abomination in the eyes of God." One of Satan's masterpieces is Islam. History proves that Allah was nothing more than the ancient moon god of the Middle East. Muhammad was doomed to hell when he rejected Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior. The devil has furnished mankind with millions of false gods to worship. In his wicked imagination, man has worshiped everything from insects to rocks, rivers, idols made with hands, and even Satan himself. To be a follower of Jesus, you must reject all of your false gods and follow him alone.
Now, in our day of religious relativism and pluralism, a debate like the one this evening is incredibly politically incorrect. All religions are supposed to be equally true, right? So what's the fuss all about? Well, the answer to that question, it seems to me, is that religious relativism, which is almost unthinkingly accepted by a great many students today, may not be true after all. It seems to me that religious relativism is, in fact, logically inconsistent and therefore cannot be true. The world's religions conceive of God or gods in so many contradictory ways that they cannot all be true. In particular, and I'm sure Dr. Badawi would agree with me here, the concept of God in Islam and Christianity is so different in crucial respects that both religions cannot be right. For example, Christians believe that God is tri-personal, that the second person of the Trinity took to himself a human nature, that Jesus of Nazareth was therefore both man and God, that in his human nature he died to pay the death penalty of sin that you and I deserved, but that God raised him from the dead, thereby showing his sacrificial death to be effective. Muslims deny all these things. We cannot both be right. We could both be wrong. Maybe it's the Buddhists who are right. But we can't both be correct. Thus, every one of us, whether Christian, Muslim, Buddhist, Hindu, atheist, agnostic, or what have you, needs to ask himself what reasons we have for thinking our persuasion to be true. Otherwise, we run the risk of being self-deluded.